Imagine, if you will, a life centuries ago, a life in the Arctic tundra of Scandinavia living among reindeer, and a life in almost complete isolation. Imagine, if you will, having a sniffle that grows into a cough, deepening into your chest until your whole body rattles with every breath. Or a blazing fever that roars untamed and leaves your body shaking, shivering, and covered in goosebumps. Imagine, if you will, the pain of a migraine, breaking a bone, or childbirth, all without the help of modern medicine. Imagine, if you will, that medicine was as much spiritual as it was natural. Imagine scavenging the land for roots, flowers, animals, and rocks to save your sick loved ones. Imagine lying on your back, gazing at the Lavu Peak while the Nuaji murmurs incantations and save your soul from the underworld beings responsible for poisoning your body. Imagine, if you will, the traditional medicine of the Sami people. Centuries before modern medicine entered even the most advanced societies, people had to live off the land to find food, shelter, and medicine. While the majority culture surged forward into scientific exploration, many old and indigenous cultures continued to rely on nature, the Sami people being one of these groups. Traditional Sami medicine is comprised of a combination of natural remedies found in the northern Scandinavian environment and reliance on a Nuaji's spiritual expertise. This presentation will describe the treatments and processes involved in healing a number of illnesses and physical problems, as well as how folk medicine is being incorporated into modern healthcare. The multiple borders crossing through Sápmi were often a hindrance to the Sami lifestyle. However, it did lead to the sharing of information across countries, resulting in similar medicinal practices throughout Scandinavia, with the Sami being more unique due to their northern isolation. Rather than practice doctors, the Sami relied on their siddhas, Nuaji, or other healers to help in medical emergencies. The extra healers were often women, as women were considered to have better and more gentle intuition for healing. In addition, much like the Sami language and stories, medicinal practices were taught to the younger generations orally. The only knowledge of traditional medicine can be found by interviewing still surviving healers or through the journals written by outsiders, either the Christian priests or traders. The medicine of the Sami consisted of animal products, botanical treatments, mineral or chemical cures, and magic. Animal products ranging from horns to urine was used to treat a wide variety of sicknesses. The most common of these treatments is cupping. Cupping is a method of bloodletting used by the Sami. Using the hollowed-out horn of an ox, a healer would place the horn on the skin of their patient and then proceed to suck on the horn until a bruise formed. From that bruise, the healer would puncture the skin to release the bad blood. This treatment is typically used to ease chest, back, hip, and even tooth pain. A peculiar use of cupping was to treat loss of appetite, in which a healer would bloodlet from the upper arch of the foot. Reindeer were a central part of Sami lifestyle and a central part of their medical treatments. Fat was used to bind large open wounds, while the bone marrow was used for smaller cuts or slashes. Reindeer hooves helped constipation, and snow blindness or cataracts could be cured by washing out the eye with reindeer urine. A common problem among Sami was frostbite. Contrary to this Norwegian method of rubbing snow on frostbite, the Sami had a more effective treatment using cheese made from reindeer milk. The oily cheese was slightly warmed and rubbed into frostbitten skin. Other animals such as bears, beavers, and even humans were used as medicine. Bear fat treated arthritis, beaver glands worked against cramps, and bile was consumed to cure stomach aches. Human breast milk treated ear aches and eye diseases, while urine was used for multiple illnesses, including coughing, sore throats, and alcohol poisoning. All animal parts and products were used in Sami culture. Nothing went to waste. This theology is also true for botanical treatments. Foraging was a major aspect of Sami culture. They gathered roots, bark, flowers, leaves, and more for many reasons, one of them being medicine. The duovli is believed to be the universal Sami medicine. Duovli is made from boiling and chopping the inner bark of an old birch, alder, or aspen with mushrooms growing on it. The bark is then set on fire and placed onto the patient, where it will stay until it has completely burned out. As painful as this process sounds, duovelin were used in treating sprains, arthritis, headaches, and other muscle or joint pains. In addition to treating illnesses or pain, plants can be used as a preventative by providing rich sources of vitamin C, such as cloudberries and crowberries. Others, such as lady's mantle, willow bark, and birch ash, were used as a salve to treat burns, rashes, open wounds, swelling, and stings. Angelica was a plant used for digestive problems, coughing, and sniffles. More interestingly, it was put in between the Sami's teeth when encountering a Norwegian in attempts to ward off any foreign sicknesses. Plant products were a valuable resource to the Sami people and to their health. The natural treatments already mentioned were often accompanied by magic or incantations from the Noaji. The reasons for illness or accidents was often thought to be the work of either Sami deities or underworld beings. The only way to contact or ward off these beings was through the Noaji. The Noaji would enter a trance-like state with the help of the Sami drum and begin to chant incantations over their patient. These spells are extremely guarded among each individual Noaji, and as a result, few are recorded. It is important to note that each chant is unique between Noaji, no two are alike since none are shared. The Noaji believe that they are a tool for the deities to work through in order to cure their patient. Therefore, the incantations are the gods' words, not their own. In addition, the Sami believed that the pain of the ill was transferred to the Noaji during the healing process, as they virtually pulled out the poison from the body. The magic of shamanistic healing almost died out during the assimilation period of Sami history, however, it is remembered through written records and memories. With the help of today's technology, scientists have discovered that many of the practices traditionally used in Sapmi are legitimate medical treatments. For example, juniper extracts were used to cure colds. Doctors and scientists now know that this plant was successful in treating patients because it contains specific oils that dissolve mucus. These same oils are in fact found in modern pharmaceuticals. Discoveries of similar traditional medicines have legitimized the practices in hospitals worldwide, especially those that often receive indigenous patients. The treatments act as a medical cure as much as it does a comforter. By providing an option for traditional Sami medicine, doctors are respecting their culture, beliefs, and are evading tensions between their respective cultures. The medicine of the Sami has been a centuries-long process of collecting information from outsiders or from trial-and-error type experiments. By using their knowledge of the land around them and their Noaji or healers as spiritual guides, the Sami were able to treat numerous medical emergencies with ease and precision. While their processes were endangered by the onslaught of colonization and Christian missionaries, their practices prevailed throughout the years and have begun to be incorporated in Scandinavian hospitals. Imagine, if you will, the traditional medicine of the Sami people. Imagine, if you will, waking up free of fever, wrapped in reindeer furs, and given birch leaves to eat to clear your once pounding head. Imagine recovering from your deep cut with the application of willow bark and reindeer fat. Imagine being healed. Imagine, if you will, a life off the land and encompassed by magic. A life of isolation, but one full of love. Imagine living far north of the reindeer in a life centuries ago. Imagine, if you will.